I guess you were saying. Welcome back to the next episode of Children's Club TV. It's Match Day Live, it's Boxing Day, and Boz, it is probably the biggest game of the season, if not many a season. 24th versus 23rd. Doesn't scream first on the EFL highlights tonight, does it? That's all he's got. Haven't seen you for a while.
No.
You've been enjoying yourself, not coming to football.
Yeah, I've not been missing it, I'll be honest.
What are you thinking in terms of today, though? Gills team fairly strong in terms, probably as strong as we can be at the moment.
Yeah, if we can work out the systems.
Yeah, we're not sure if it's a 4-3-3 or whether Adelican's going to play as a striker. We can work out the rest. It's Jake Turner in goal. It's a back four of Robbie McKenzie, Max Emar, Elkan Bagger and David Tatonda. If it is a diamond, it'll likely be Sean Williams at the base with O'Keefe and Jeffries from the sides, and then Ben Rees in the 10. With Adelican playing next to Mika Mandel. It could be a flat three. It could be O'Keefe, Williams and Jeffries, and then Adelican and Rees playing from the sides. Ollie Lee back out of the squad after making a brief appearance in the cup against Wolves in the week.
Callum
Harriott on the bench. No Lewis Walker ill. No Ryan Law ill. Still got some sort of sickness bug sweeping the squad. Colchester, John Akindi starts. Is he going to ruin the takeover shenanigans, party, whatever we want to call it, because we do have to touch on it. Brad Gallinson officially confirmed as the new owner on Friday. Merry Christmas and a happy birthday to Boz, but we do not want to get too ahead of ourselves because this is essentially the same group of players. We've not signed anyone yet, so it doesn't mean we're going to roll up today and win 5 or 6-0. Score prediction. I'm going to go a nervy 1-0 win for the Gills.
Yeah, but I mean, with people just kind of, when it gets personal like that, you tend to not give these people any sort of credit. I knew it was coming, this, but I just want to see it announced that night.
Not long to kick off now. Gills v Colchester, joined quickly by Glenn and Stocky. We've all seen the team. We're all smiling because of Friday's takeover. But matters for the next 2 hours are, of course, the matter of 3 points. Stocky, what are you thinking in terms of a score prediction today?
2-1. I think some of their players up the front, then I don't know
who's
real.
Glenn?
I reckon 2-0, actually, to be fair. The takeover is fantastic. Best Christmas spread that I've had for many years. But inherently, things haven't changed yet. It's still the same team from a few weeks ago. We still have our problems on the pitch. Let's hope to say it gives them a kick up the backside. I think 2-0, an entertaining draw.
Enjoy the game, fellas. Come on, Ben Rees, good one. It's got to go back. It's got to be a better delivery. Touch and box. Yes, get up. Straight through to the keeper. John Akindi getting a bit of stick, we call it, from the rain a minute, but he's probably been their biggest threat. Twice he's got good balls into the 6-yard box. But he's bullying Elkan Bagger at the moment a little bit. But as is the norm, we've pulled apart. Over an A takeover, Boz. Not a lot's changing on the pitch. 1-0 down. It's really poor from our point of view, isn't it? Mandron, you said, done really well at the start. Pulled it out of the sky. Nope. But then he has too many touches. Mandron loses it. Simple ball across the box. We all get sucked out to it, and it's quite a feeble effort that trickles apologetically into the back of the net. work to do. Need to score twice to win a football match.
Corner for the Gills. Was it half an appeal for a penalty for handball? Oh, what now? This is just getting dark.
Referee just wants to have a chat with everyone.
Try again. Ben Reeves might take the corner. Here it comes. Get up. It's good defending. Delacombe. Gotta be stronger there, yeah. That'd be a foul as well. No, he's not giving it, but not good enough. Free kick to the Gills boss, but Elkin Baggett's having one of them afternoons that he'll quickly want to forget. Already been. Yeah, and now he's just sold Jake Turner short with a back pass. Luckily, Turner managed to get enough on him, but let's see if we can make something from this set piece. Ben Reeves straight there, and the keeper's throw. Takeover or no takeover, same old problems remain.
Oh yeah, it's been absolutely awful. You would have thought the takeover would have given some of these players a boost, like I said when we done the score predictions at the start. But it's been up there, one of the worst performances. First shot on target, until the 42nd minute. It's just not, we haven't played anything.
Don't know what that was.
That was the Williams header. Come down with snow on it. The delivery from set pieces when we've had them haven't been good enough. We haven't created enough, even at the stupid thing. Had a Luke and a McKenzie on the right hand side. The right ball don't get played, and when it does, McKenzie plays it behind on a Luke and who slips over. For me, that sums it up. Colchester, we make them look as if they're at the top of the league.
Yep.
McKinney's running our defence ragged. This is not great.
What do you make of the system? I've just tweeted, Mick Harris has got it wrong for me. If we're setting up to not lose against the side one place above us, then we've got real issues. I know we've got real issues, but you know what I mean.
Yeah, I mean, it's a bit of a weird one. For me at the moment, it doesn't matter what system we play, what personnel are in that system, it's just not good enough throughout the club, throughout the starting 11. Subs that come on, I just got to that point where you just can't see much happening. When you go a goal down, the best you can hope for is a draw.
Which leads us where we were at kickoff, so still bottom of the league. Would you make changes at the break? It's quite out of pace for me.
I think I'd get cracked on. You just need some aggression up there.
I'd also take one of Williams or O'Keefe off and put Jeffries deeper and get some more pace into
Williams
the final third.
Williams looks a bit leggy, I think. Green doesn't, I mean, none of them stood out, let's be honest. Mangold hasn't done much, but you can probably make a few changes. But like I said, whoever you bring on, it just seems to be the same, whoever that 11 is out on the pitch at the moment. It's very depressing after what should have been a good week after the news on 21st.
Yeah, another long 45 minutes in store, I can imagine. Wow, that explains the nutshell.
Rolling about the
bad one for Ben Reeves, unfortunately, was when he turned to chase the ball and no one near him collapsed. Like you say, tried to get straight back up and then rolled around in agony and there's some stretches out and oxygen. Been a long delay already, ankle or knee, I'd say. Sad to see, he's just got himself fit again in the last few weeks as well, but can't see him playing for quite a while.
Ben Reeves is number 7, Alex McDonald. The attendance at Men's Crystal Second today is 4,962, 4,962, of whom 420 come from Colchester, the former capital city of the United Kingdom. Sub for the Gills, that is an 8 Stuart O'Keefe, that is 24 Scott Pashkin. And replacing 21 Hakeem Adelikun is 15 Callum Harrier.
Paul from Williams again. I mean, we said okay for him, it didn't really matter which one went off, did it? Because they've both been as poor as each other, but it's another lazy foul. That ball in, where's that gone? It's gone out. Gills! Yeah, they look like they want it more than us, yeah. We made a couple of changes now. Scott Cashkin's come on as well. Yeah, he did, yeah, managed. It's good height for him, but he still had to make the stop. 28 minutes to save our season, Dale.
First time
it brings
a chance to lob one in, I think. Here it comes. Baggett's got to win it. John Kennedy's defended it really well. Nothing at all. Maybe to Thomas White. I think Gill's bench are actually seeing if he's okay.
Free kick to Cole Hugh, we've got to defend. Does Mika Mandrill only win headers in his own box? Yeah. That seems to be it.
He did one down now, he did.
Well done, Callum Harris. Free kick to halfway on. Jordan Green's got one for David Totonda. Guess the system, I think, is the game at the moment.
Get it along.
Yeah, and just hope that it falls for someone.
Clock's just ticked over 80. He's telling the linesman to watch it, but he's not even looking at him. Just go down, LK. Oh, that's a good header to be fair. Keep it alive, Jordan. Stay with it. Come on, Jordan. Hey! Free kick to Gills, 20 yards out. Where's Will Wright when you need him?
Alex McDonald looks like he's lining this up. Don't need to shoot.
Corner for Gills, 8-4 on the clock, Callum Harriott to take it.
That is such a poor set piece again.
That's all right, didn't he barely got into the box. Sean Williams done well, stay with it. It's got to be good, Harriott. He's got Cashkit. Harriott, Callum Harriott, Callum Harriott! Block, corner for Gills, come on!
Get up.
Baggett! He's got to hit the target. It's a free header, 8 yards out, and he's missed the target. Yeah, that was the chance. Still 1-0 down.
8 minutes of the minute, there's been about three of that play. There's been a huge delay again. Corner, McDonald. Sean Williams,
where's that going?